Hey guys, what's going on? It's Don here from Novaspirit Tech, and today we are going to be adding voice activation to our Google Assistant on Raspberry Pi. So let's get started. So before we begin, I gotta say, what do you guys think of my glasses? No, I'm just kidding. I really wanted to talk about my Patreon, something that could help support the channel. Now, if you guys can't do that, please at least consider sharing this video, either with your grandmother, your grandfather, use your dog's Instagram account to share it. Any way to share the video will help me. So sorry for the delay on this video. I actually wanted to get this out a lot earlier, but then again, Google is actually working on their code, and I didn't want anything that I did will affect what their changes would be. So I waited for their code to come out. And to our benefit, they actually added voice activation to their Google Assistant. So I'm basically just going to run through their tutorial and show you guys how to do it. All right, guys, so we're going to be using a fresh install of Raspbian and Pixel, and make sure you have all the updates and everything. And the first thing we want to do is go into your browser and then go into https://console.cloud.google.com/project. That will actually bring you up to a project menu. From here, you just need to sign in. The first thing you want to do is actually create a project. So navigate over to the top and hit create project. And then you can name it anything you want. For me, just for the sake of ease, I just named it voice. And then hit create. Now give it a few seconds because it might not show up right away. Eventually it will show up. Now, as soon as it does, you could hit the three squiggly lines and then head over to API Manager. From here, we're just gonna enable the Google Assistant services. But you wanna hit the drop down and then select the project you're working with. So hit all. And then click on voice, and that's what I named my project. Here, you can now search for your project, call it, it's called Google Assistant. They have so much projects, so you just wanna search for it. Click on that, and then on the top right, you should be able to hit enable. All right, once you got that done, the next thing you wanna do is actually give it an OAuth key. So we're gonna go over to credentials, and we're gonna do OAuth consent screen. Now, you can name the project anything you want, but I just named it voice. It's the same thing. That way it's easier. And then you could hit save. When you're done with that, we're gonna have to create a new credential. So hit the little button in the middle called create credentials, and then go to OAuth client ID. From here, you just select other, and again, just name it voice. Everything is so easy that way. When it's done, it's gonna pop up a box. You don't have to worry about this because we're actually gonna download the key. That's why we're doing this whole thing off our Raspberry Pi, so we could just download this JSON key. So stretch out the screen and then hit download. Now you have that. Now, if you are doing this for the first time, you might need to enable some permissions for your account so you could use the Google Assistant. So we're gonna navigate over to https://myaccount.google.com/activity-control. From here, just make sure you have web activity enabled, location history enabled, and device information enabled, and also voice audio activity enabled. And then it's gonna not scream about permission issues and stuff like that when you start the project. Now here comes the fun part. We're gonna go into terminal, and I'm gonna make the font a little bit bigger for you guys. And we're gonna do sudo apt-get update, just to make sure we have all the updates. Next, we're gonna install our Python. So sudo apt-get install python3-dev and then python-venv. Okay, once that's done, we're gonna go into that. So python3-menv, sorry about that. It'll actually create all the folder structures that you need for the environment. Then you would want to type in env /python-m pip and then install or upgrade pip again or and setup tools. Now that we're done with that, we're going to jump into our environment. So we're going to source env /bin/activate. All right, this is a long command and I actually typoed this like four times wrong. So I'm going to leave all the links and everything what you need to type in the description below. But that's one of them. And then here's another long command that we're gonna eventually need to type. So again, I'm gonna leave all the links in the description. But basically this is getting the Google Authentication OAuth services or libraries and everything for this. And once you're done with this command, it's gonna install everything. And now we could actually go into our authentication tool or OAuth tool. And here, again, long command. Okay, now that that command is done, what you need to do is right-click the link and copy URL and paste it into our browser. This will allow us to get the authorization key so we can enter in the terminal. As soon as that's done, you see that key that's right in the middle. Select all on that and then right-click and copy it. Now we just need to paste it into a terminal. So right-click on the terminal and then hit paste. Once you're done with that, that's it. You just could start up Google Assistant by google-assistant-demo. Hey Google, what's the weather like in New York?
Right now in New York City, it's 57 and cloudy. Today, it'll be rainy with a forecasted high of 63 and a low of 59.
So guys, thanks for watching this video. If you guys liked it, please hit that like button. If you guys got any questions, hit it up in the comments below. Now I'm planning to take this a step further and install everything onto a Raspberry Pi Zero and all that stuff. So please subscribe to this channel if you haven't done so already. And as I say in my nerd cave, hack till it hurts.